Greetings. I'm sorry I was not there today. So I have completed the lab and I will post that in a separate YouTube video. Remember that we are skipping chapter 2 for right now and we're going to do the next chapter, which is chapter 3. So it starts out on page 69 of your book. What you will need to remember is there is a law called the Law of Mass Conservation that says that matter cannot be created or destroyed. It can only change forms. And so the lab that we have done, well, I have done and you will watch, is mixing some things together. You can see a chemical reaction happening. You can feel a chemical reaction happening, but the matter still is all there. It weighs the same when it starts and when it ends. And that's important. It's kind of common sense, but it's important to be able to know that that's what happens for some different problems that we'll figure out. So if you should write up the lab 3.1. If you want to do it at home, that's fine. If you want to just watch what I did, that's fine. Lye is a little bit difficult to come by. It's at the most hardware stores if you really want to do it. But you can just watch what I did, write up the results. It's going to basically be, it weighed the same as what it started when it ended. But your conclusion should be that mass was conserved. And you can read problem step 21 on your lab. That's actually a good conclusion. So we're going to jump to example 3.1. This is on page 73. A chemist notices that when given enough energy, a certain white powder changes into two different substances, tin and oxygen. A chemist watches 151 grams of powder undergo this change. The chemist easily collects the tin that was formed and measures its mass to be 119 grams, but the chemist could not collect the oxygen that was formed and therefore cannot determine its mass. So, use the law of mass conservation to help the chemist determine how much oxygen was made. Simple. So if he had 151 grams, maybe if my pen works, 151 grams to start with, and he was able to collect 119 grams of tin, if you subtract those two, you will figure out how much oxygen there was. If it only has oxygen and tin making up this substance, then everything that was lost in the air will be what is the difference between these two numbers. So remember, you have to take into consideration significant digits. So when you're adding and subtracting significant digits, I think I'm going to switch colors here. When you're adding and subtracting significant digits, you round to the least significant place. This is not even any better. We'll get a good one. All right, so 151 minus 119 is going to give us 32 grams. So I round to this place. Okay, when I'm multiplying and dividing, I would count how many significant digits I have, and that's how many I would have in my answer. But when I'm adding and subtracting, I round to the least significant place. So, I know that they had 32 grams of oxygen formed. Okay, so everybody will get a copy of the periodic table. We will use this the rest of the year. I made you copies. They're not pretty colors like this, so if you want to make a copy of this and have it in different colors, that's fine. But I have a black and white one to give you. Hopefully today you had a lab and a test to turn in for chapter 1. I will correct those first thing next week and get them back to you before second period. So the periodic table is important. It has all of the compounds that are found in Earth and ones that they've actually kind of created. And if you look on the periodic table, I'm going to take this one because it's easier. There's a little zigzag line right here. And everything on this side of the zigzag line is going to be a metal. And everything on this side of the zigzag line, zigzag right here, is going to be a nonmetal. And if you can't remember, you might want to know that C is carbon, O is oxygen. You are mostly made of carbon. You are not metallic. So things over here are nonmetals. So compounds then are, these are elements. And a compound then is any two elements that are joined together, two or more elements that are joined together as a compound. And those compounds join together in fixed numbers. So the law of definite proportions tells you that the proportion of elements in any compound is always the same too. So they go through, make sure you read your book. They show you where they have 10 grams on page 79, 10 grams of sodium meeting with 10 grams of chlorine, and they actually make 16.5 grams of table salt, which is sodium chloride, and then you have leftover sodium. So you're able to figure out exactly kind of the recipe to make sodium chloride. It's kind of like when I'm making chocolate chip cookies and I have a recipe which has flour and sugar and eggs and butter. I probably don't use all the butter or all the eggs in my house when I make chocolate chip cookies. I only use what the recipe calls for. If I add all of my eggs or all of my flour, my cookies aren't going to turn out very well. They only turn out well if I have used the exact recipe. So recipe for what we would call a recipe making food, we call the compounds when we're making a recipe for mixing of different elements together. And they're always joined together in whole numbers. So you never get half of a sodium to mix to make a salt. It's always in whole numbers. So let's do example 3.2. A chemist reacts 15 grams of calcium with 15 grams of oxygen, and this reaction makes 21 grams of a compound known as lime. So I have 15 grams of calcium and 15 grams of oxygen. And it mixes together to make 21 grams of lime. And I hope you can see that 15 and 15 does not equal 21. So the recipe isn't 15 grams of calcium for 15 grams of oxygen. We're going to have the extra of something. So it says, along with the lime, there is leftover oxygen plus oxygen. Can you read that? Oxygen. So if a chemist wants to make 55 grams of lime and not have any leftover oxygen or calcium, how much of each element should he use? So first you have to figure out what the recipe is. So to figure out what the recipe is, we're going to see, I know that the extra of this is going to be this leftover oxygen. So this would have made 30 grams of something. So I would subtract 21 from 30. And whatever's left over is going to be my leftover oxygen. So 30 minus 21 is 9.0 grams of leftover oxygen. So the recipe then would be, what's 15 minus 9? 15 minus 9 is going to be 6. I use 6.0 grams of oxygen to make my recipe. So that means I use all of the calcium and 6 grams of oxygen. So if my recipe then, recipe is 15.0 grams of calcium and 6.0 grams of oxygen, that gives me 21.0 grams. Okay. So, and I have leftover oxygen. So now the second part of this question says, if he wants to make 55 grams of lime then and not have any more leftover oxygen, I would have to ramp up this recipe. So instead of making 21 grams, I want to make 55 grams. So what do I have to multiply 21 by? That's a question mark. Okay, my handwriting's terrible. What do I have to multiply 21 by to get 55? So if you take, I have it upside down. If you take 55.0 divided by 21.0, you're going to get a ratio. So, and it's going to be 2.6. So you're going to find out what you have to multiply your recipe by to get how much you want. When I make chocolate chip cookies, I usually I can multiply it by 1.5 times, 2 times, 3 times. If I'm making it for a big party, I might have to do 10 times. So you can multiply up or multiply down. So you take what you want over how much the recipe makes, and you figure out we're making 2.6 times the recipe. So then you take 2.6 times your calcium and 2.6 times your oxygen, and that's going to tell you exactly how much you're going to make. So you take 2.6 times 15 is going to be, I don't think you can see it if I write it up there. So 2.6 times 15 is going to give you 39 grams. Did you notice that I should write it down. 15.0 times 2.6, when I'm multiplying, I can only multiply, this only has two significant digits, so my answer has two significant digits. This has three significant digits, but I have to use two significant digits because that's my least significance. So, and this 55, and I got that also because we're making 55 grams, which only has two significant digits. So, I'm going to need 39 grams of calcium, and then I'm going to take 6.0 times 2.6 to figure out how much oxygen, and that is 16 grams of oxygen. So, just so you know, I use chocolate chip cookie baking in many of my examples, just because who doesn't love chocolate chip cookies? All right, so next time we'll talk more about the law of multiple proportions and Dalton's atomic theory. So that's all we're going to get through today. Again, hopefully you turned in a lab and a test, and next week you should turn in a lab after you watch my YouTube video, and hopefully we'll be there next week to have a fun discussion and a good lab. Okay? We'll see you next time. Bye.